At next, so valuation of rights. So how their rights is valued? When a company offers new shares to the existing shareholders, it is always issued at the lowest price or lower price as per the market price. So lower than the market price. So existing shareholders will get the monetary benefits from right issue. So they will get the monetary benefits to the shareholders. And also valuation of right. When a company offers new shares to the existing shareholders, it always issue at a much lower price than the market price. So existing shareholders will get the monetary benefits. The monetary benefits arising to the existing shareholders from right issue is known as value of right. So valuation of right. The monetary benefits. Arise to the existing shareholder from right issue, is known as valuation of right. So as you know, right issue is nothing but the issue of shares, to the existing shareholders at a discounted price. So they will have a monetary benefit because they will have the shares at a discounted price. So valuation of right is nothing but they will get the monetary benefits. Who? For the existing shareholders, they will have the monetary benefits to the existing shareholders from the right issue, that is known as valuation of right. So one formula is there, formula to know the valuation of right, that is formula to calculate right value of right. So valuation of right equals to valuation of right equals to right share divided by total share. Into market price minus issue price. So how to calculate value of right or valuation of right? So valuation of right equals to right share divided by total share into market price minus issue price. This is the formula to calculate the valuation of right. So to calculate valuation of right share divided by total share into market price minus issue price. So to calculate the value of right, this is the formula. So we will take one problem on valuation of right. So X Company Limited company offers to the existing equity shareholders the right to buy one equity share of rupees 100 each at rupees 120 for every 4 equity shares of 100 each of the market price of rupees 170 per share. This is one problem related to valuation of right. So we will have one problem related to valuation of right. This is the formula to calculate the valuation of right. So first thing, X Limited company offers to the existing equity shareholders to buy one equity share of rupees 100 each. So right to buy one equity share, that is at rupees 100 each. At rupees 120 for every 4 equity shares. Of 100 each.
Issue price for 100 each at ₹140 issue price.
That is value of right would be how much?
Equals to, we will take here only 1/5 into how much? That is 50. So calculate. That is 1/5, 50/5. That is how much? ₹10. So therefore, value of rights equals to ₹10.
This is the problem related to valuation of right. So right to buy equity share, right to buy one equity share, that 1 plus for every 4 equity share ₹100 each. 4 plus 1 equity, that is 5 equity share for 5th, that is right share 1/5 into issue market price 170, issue price 120, that would be 1/5 into 170 minus 120, that would be 1/5 into 50, that would be ₹10. Value of right would be ₹10. So this is one problem related to valuation of right. So the problem of valuation of right, it is to calculate valuation of right. So Krishna Limited wishes to increase its funds by making rights issue of equity share to finance its expansion. The existing company of the share capital of the company is ₹80 lakhs. The market value of shares is ₹45. The company offers to the shareholders of the right to buy 5 shares at ₹12 each for every 15 shares. So they have given one problem, that is related to Krishna Limited. They wishes to increase the funds by making right issue. So existing equity share capital of that Krishna Limited is 80 lakhs, market value is ₹45, and right to buy 5 shares at ₹12 each for every 15 shares. So they have told to calculate the value of right. So they have told to calculate the value of right. So value of right equals to what? Right share divided by total share. Right share divided by total share into what? Market price minus issue price. That is market price minus issue price. So this is formula to calculate the valuation of right. So valuation of right equals to right share. So right share is how much? Right to buy 5 shares, that is equals to 5/5 total share, that is for 15 share plus 5 share, that would be 20 into what is the market price? So market value that would be 45 minus what is the issue price? Issue price that is would be 12. So equals to 45 minus 12. So calculated. 5 by 20 into 13 3 equals to how much? 5 into 33 by 20. That is 8.25. So value of right equals to 8.25. The value of right is ₹8.25. So existing shareholder capital 80 lakhs. So they want to make an increase of fund. So that's why they have given market value 45, right to buy shares at rupees 12 each. Okay, right to buy shares, that is at rupees 12 each. This is the issue price and market value is 45 rupees. So for calculating the value of right equals to right share divided by total share into market price minus issue price, that would be right share, that would be right to buy 5 shares. So 5 right share, that is 5 by 20. So total share, that is 5 shares plus 15 shares. So right to buy 5 shares as well as for every 15 shares. So 20 shares, total shares into market price 45, market value that is 45, and also issue price that is at 12 each. So that would be valuation of right full would be 8.25. This is the problem related to valuation of right. So next is delisting. Delisting of securities. So delisting of securities. So delisting means that is removal of securities from a listing company from a stock exchange. That is removal. Removal of securities from stock exchange. So that is delisting of securities is nothing but a removal of securities from the stock exchange. So removal of securities of a leasing company from a stock exchange. And also in December 1998, the Mumbai Stock Exchange has threatened to delist shares of over 700 companies from non-payment of leasing fee. So in December 1988, the Bombay Stock Exchange, that is Mumbai Stock Exchange, removed 800 companies for non-payment of fees. Okay, and also over the past year several companies incurred losses
and many of them were unable to pay a listing fee. So in that situation, they are unable to pay listing fees for the Mumbai Stock Exchange. But many companies purposefully avoided paying the fees. So some companies, due to losses, they are not paid. So some other companies purposefully avoided for paying the fees of listing fees. So delisting of company shares provides the public company or public scrutiny of performance. Many companies made public issue itself a business. Thus delisting may be compulsory or voluntary. Some of the causes for the delisting are as follows. So compulsory as well as voluntary.
So there is compulsory delisting and voluntary delisting. So first thing, compulsory delisting.
So in that, why they have made delisting of companies means, that is removal of securities or companies from listing and making delisting. So first one, non-payment of listing fees.
Non-payment of listing fees. Listing fees.
So due to non-payment of listing fees, the removal of securities from the stock exchange. So the companies were removed from listing due to non-payment of listing fees and negligible trading. Negligible trading. So due to negligible trading, the listing companies, from listing company, they have made a unlisting company, that is delisted from that part, that is removal of securities from a listed company from a stock exchange. So non-redressal, and last non-redressal grievance of grievances. So any unfair practices, so due to unfair practices, they have removed company from listed. So they have delisted, that companies are made delisted because of non-redressal of grievances, that is due to unfair practices. So due to unfair practices, they have removed from listing. And also unfair trade practices.
Unfair trade practices.
So due to unfair trade practices, they have removed from listing. So that is nothing but malpractices. So malpractices, and also issue of duplicate fake shares. So issue of fake shares,
or duplicate shares. Shares are issued
. So these are the some unfair trade practices. So that's why they have removed. So this is the compulsory delisting. So delisting. So these are the some compulsory delisting, that is taking off from the listing that is removal of securities of a listed company from a stock exchange due to unfair trade practices, non-redressal of grievances or negligence trading or non-payment of listing fees. So due to this, these are the compulsory delisting of a companies. So next thing about the voluntary delisting. So some of the voluntary delisting.
Securities.